Good morning, dear students. A very warm good morning to all of you. So, in our previous lecture, we have discussed about the food from plants, and today we will start the next point from the same lesson. The lesson name is what? Sources of food. And today we will discuss the next point from the lesson, that is food from animals. So, first only we have discussed that there are the two main sources of plant. There are two main sources of food, which are plants and animals. So, there are the certain animals, those who are also giving us, those who are also providing us different types of the food stuffs. So, let's discuss which are that animal and we have what type of the food material they are giving us. So, first we'll discuss about the milk. So, as we know, milk we are getting from the animals. There are the different animals, those who are providing us, those who are giving us milk. For example, we can say that we get milk from cows, buffaloes and goats. Okay, so these are the milk providing animal. They give us milk, and this milk is used for the several other purposes, or we can say that from that milk we are preparing the milk products like curd, ghee, butter, cheese, paneer, ice creams also we can mix from the milk. Okay, so this milk is the one of the food stuff or the food material that we are getting from animals. Now the next one, that is eggs. Okay, so the eggs also we are getting from the animals, like we get the eggs from hens, turkeys and the ducks. Okay, so these eggs are we are getting from the animals like hens, turkeys and the ducks, and these hens are helps to build our body. It is a very good source of vitamins and the proteins also. Okay, so next one, that is what? Eggs, just now we have discussed, and now next we will discuss, that is meat. So meat is also the very good, or it is also the rich source of protein, and as we know, protein helps us to build our body. From which animals we are getting the milk? Let's see. We get milk from hen, ducks, goat and fish. So these are the certain animals, their meat we are eating, and by eating the meat we are getting the enough, or we are getting the more amount of protein, which helps to build our body. So which animals gives us meat? We get the meat from hen, ducks, goats and fish. Now the next one, which is very important also, that is nothing but honey. So as we know, everyone knows that there is a honeybee which gives us honey. So we get the honey from honeybees, but the thing is that how the honeybees provide us milk, or how that honeybees gives us milk, how we are getting the honey. So for all these questions, there is a very big story, like we can say, or there is a very big story is there. So we will discuss that. So honeybees are collecting the nectar from the flower. Now what is mean by nectar? So nectar is nothing but it is the sweet juice, okay, which is present in a flower. So nectar means what? It is a sweet juice which is present in a flower. So honeybees collected that juice, sweet juice, that is nectar, and collected in their house. That house of the honeybees we are calling as a hives. Okay, so they are storing that nectar in the hives. Okay, and from that nectar they are making the very tasty nutritious honey. So in this way we are getting the honey, and the honey is also the very good source of carbohydrate because it is a sweet in the taste. Okay, and honeybees are also having the very good amount of nourishment value. They are providing us nourishment and it is very tasty also. There is one medicinal property for the honeys also. The honeys are also used in the medicine tablets, or to make the certain types of the medicine honeys are using, honey is using. So all these about the honeys. So next one is there, we will discuss about the apiculture. So what is meant by apiculture? Let's see. The rearing of honeybees on a large scale is called apiculture. First we will discuss about what is meant by rearing. Now rearing means what? To keeping the certain animals with us with a large number, feed them on a time, or we have to take care of them, and after that they are providing us different types of the products. Okay, so here we are rearing the animal. Here we are rearing the honeybees. Why we are rearing the honeybees? Because honeybees gives us honey. Okay, so the rearing of honeybees, we are keeping the honeybees on a large scale. Why? To get the enough amount of honey. That process is called as what? Apiculture. Okay, so the rearing of honeybees on a large scale is called as apiculture, and from that apiculture we are getting the more amount of honeys. Okay, so all these are the different products that we are getting from the animal. All these are the different food things that we are getting from animals. So let's revise again what we are getting from the animal. We are getting the milk from cows, buffaloes and goat. We are getting the eggs from hen, turkeys and ducks. Meat from hen, ducks, goat and fish. We are getting the honey from honeybees. And what is mean by apiculture? The rearing of honeybees on a large scale is called apiculture. Okay, so this is all about today. Today I will end my point, and the next point we will discuss in the next lecture. For today, thank you.